morning students. So far we have discussed in this exercise 14.2 till question number 9. So let's resume our discussion of this exercise. So let's see one more type. So in question number 10, a amount of 1870 has to be divided into 3 parts such that half of first part. So I will take let parts equal to x, y and z. So what is given? Half of first part. Half of first part means x by 2 is equal to 1/3 of second part, that is y upon 3 is equal to 1/6 of third part, that is z upon 6. Okay, so this is what is given as equal. So how we can solve this? Let all these parts is equal to, suppose a. Okay, so what I will get from here, x upon 2 equal to a, that is x equal to 2a, then y upon 3 equal to a, y equal to 3a, and z upon 6 equal to a, z equal to 6a. Okay, so I got all the values in terms of a. Now what we know? We know that x plus y plus z is equals to 1870. Okay, so I will substitute all the values here. So what I will get? Put values of x, y and z. So it is 2a plus 3a plus 6a is equals to 1870. That will give you. And what is a I got? A I got 170. Okay, so this is the value of a. Now what is our answer? Answer is what? First part is equals to how much? 2a, that is 2 into 170. Then second part is equals to 3 into 170, and the third part is equals to 6 into 170. Okay, so in this we have to take 3 variables, then after these 3 variables I have reduced all the 3 variables into a single variable. Half of first part is equals to 1/3 of second part is equals to 1/6 of the third part. Then let's discuss few problems related to the fractions. So now I will discuss the problems related to the fractions. So in this, a problem is there. The denominator of fraction is 12 more than the numerator. So let numerator is equals to x. So what is denominator? Denominator I will get. What is denominator as given? 12 more than the numerator, that is 12 plus x. Then if 16 is added to both numerator and denominator, so if 16 is added, so what is now numerator? Numerator will be x plus 16, and what is denominator now? X plus 12 was previously, plus 16 is added, so it becomes x plus 28. Okay, 16 is added to both numerator and denominator, so the fraction becomes 10 upon 13. So new fraction is, what is fraction? X plus 16 upon x plus 28, and it is equals to 10 upon 13. Okay, so now again it becomes an equation that we have already solved. We will do the cross multiplication. So 13 into x plus 16 is equals to 10 into x plus 28. So it will give you 13x plus 208 is equals to 10x plus 280. Then all the variables on one side, all the constants on one side, we will get 3x equal to 72, or x equal to 72 upon 3, that is 24. Okay, so what is our answer? Answer was x upon x plus 12, that is 24 upon 24 plus 12, that is 24 upon 36. Okay, this was numerator, that was the denominator. So what was the fraction? Fraction you will get x upon x plus 12. So this is how you can solve the problems related to the fraction. First you will take whatever is given in the relation with denominator is given in relation with numerator. So I have taken numerator as x. 16 is added, so I have added 16 to both. The new fraction becomes 10 upon 13. 10 upon 13 it becomes. Then after solving, I got x equals to 24. Then after putting the value, I got fraction as 24 upon 36. Okay, so let's discuss few problems related to ages now, important one. So what is given? The sum of ages of Seema and Gaurav is 31 years. After 10 years, ratio of their ages will be 8:9. So what we will do? Let age of Gaurav equal to x. So what is the age of Seema then? And since their age sum was their age sum was 31, so Gaurav age is x, so Seema age is 31 minus x, and this is the what present age. Okay, this we have to find. After 10 years, so we will calculate age after 10 years. So what is the age of Gaurav? Present age was x, after 10 years it becomes x plus 10. And what is the age of Seema? 31 minus x was the present age, after 10 years it becomes 41 minus x. Now what is the condition given? The ratio of their ages, that is ratio of Seema age to the Gaurav age, is 8:9. That is 41 minus x upon x plus 10 is equals to 8 upon 9. So again we will do the cross multiplication as usual. We are doing 41 minus x, x plus 10. So how much it becomes? 369 minus 9x equal to 8x plus 80. Then all the variables on one side and all the constants on one side. So it is 17x minus 289. So minus is cancel out, you will get 289 upon 17, that is 17. So what is our answer? Answer will be Gaurav's age is how much? 17 years. And Seema's age is how much? 31 minus 17, that is 14 years. Okay. So in these type of questions, the age problems, we will take the present age as the variable. Afterwards, whatever years are given, we add those years. If it is later, then plus, and if it is ago, then it becomes minus. Okay, let's discuss one more problem. So in this 17th question, it is given that Anita is twice as old as Mahesh. So let the age of Mahesh is X. So Anita is twice means Anita becomes 2X. Okay, again, these are the present ages. Okay. So now previous question, we have taken 10 years later. Now it is 10 years ago. So today Mahesh is X years old. Before 10 years, he will be X minus 10. Anita's present age is 2x. So before 10 years, it will be 2x minus 10. So now, what is the condition is given? 10 years ago, Anita's age is what? 7 times as Mahesh age. That is 2x minus 10 is 7 into x minus 10. So finally we form a linear equation. Now we will solve it. So it is 2x minus 10 is equals to 7x minus 70. Then 2x minus 7x equal to minus 70 plus 10. So I will get minus 5x equal to minus 60. X equal to 60 by 5, that is 12. So what is our answer? In this, what is asked? Present ages. So Mahesh age is how much? 12 years. And Anita's age is 12 into 2, that is 24 years. Okay. Okay, so this is it. So we have discussed questions till question number 17. In the next video, we will discuss questions after question number 17.